study showing that the MEHP levels increase when the endothelial microparticle increase. And the summation of DHP is a summation of MEHP, MEHHP, and MEOHP. These are three combinations, and we have the summation of DHP. And this is the MMBP and the MIBP. We found that it's associated with the endothelial microparticle. And here, showing the figure. And we look at the plasma microparticle, the MEHP, summation DHP, and MIBP, MMBP is associated, positive associate. Here, we found the plasma microparticle, MEHP, and the summation DHP. And how about the microparticle and the cardiovascular risk factor? So we found the blood pressure SBP and the BMI and LDL label and the triglyceride label and the insulin resistance marker as the hallmark is a positive associated with the microparticles. And the HDL is negative associated with the microparticles. So for every increase of one log MEHP, the DHP metabolite, the increase of the microparticle can be shown here. The 0.132 for the endothelial microparticle, and plasma microparticle and 0.117. And so another estimate that we checked for an IQR increase in interquartile range increase in the DHP metabolite MEHP, and we found that the microparticle will increase 6.68%. And here is the plasma microparticle will increase 3.65%. So it's a small conclusion that is a clear positive association was found between the urinary MEHP and the microparticle from the endothelial and platelets in adolescent and young adult. This study provides scientific evidence of the atherogenic effect of DHP phthalate exposure. The second study, we are looking at a positive association between the MEHP and the insulin resistance and the low the testosterone levels. This is the same study subject. The MEHP at here, we found that it's significant associated with the insulin resistance hormone IR. And the testosterone level is directly associated with the hormone IR. And we look at the MEHP exposure and the insulin resistance at here, insulin, and the testosterone is negative. It is after controlling after risk factors. So we look at the among the adolescent and the young adult, and we found the young adult is more clear association with the solid exposure. However, the young adult, the adolescent is not so clear. So we have a scheme to demonstrate that the MEHP interaction between the testosterone and the insulin resistance. So this is just published in this month. So urine DHP metabolite MEHP associated with the fasting insulin and the hormone IR independent of the covariate in young adult. So this study highlights the diabetogenic potential of the phthalate exposure. Another study that is we are trying to demonstrate the association between the phthalate exposure and oxidation stress. We know lipid oxidation is the product is 8-iso isoprotein, and another is the DNA the adduct that is oxidation stress. We can measure the AOHDG. So after all, it's 751 subjects included in these studies. And we found that the log MMP label and the log BZP labels that is associated with the lipid oxidation and the DNA oxidation markers. So for every increase, one unit increase in the nature log transform MMP labels. And the 8-OHDG at here, and the isoprotein, prostan at here, increase the levels of the oxidation stress. And the similar pattern in the MBGP, we found that there's more clear in the 8-isoprostan at here. So this study, we want to show that the solid exposure and the subclinical atherosclerosis in adolescent and young adult, because we have demonstrated the endothelial dysfunction marker and the diabetes marker and oxidation stress marker. And how about this combination can be associated with the subclinical atherosclerosis? So this study, we're using 789 subjects in this association study. We measure the internal carotid artery, carotid valve, and common carotid artery. And this, we have demonstrated in...
Zifam, caring for well-being.